Hey guys, so today I'm going to be sharing with you my November favorites, and I'm sorry that this is late, but if you've been keeping up with me on my vlog channel, you know I've been a little crazy this month, so I wanted to take some time to sit down and film this favorites video for you guys because I did have a few products I wanted to share with you and just some things I've been really loving. So if you do like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And if you guys don't know, I am doing Vlogcember, so I vlog every day until Christmas. I know a ton of people are doing it this year and I have not missed a day, so... So if you want to see the vlogs that I'm doing, I will leave my channel down below. You can kind of see my dogs and just go along with me for the month. So yeah, let's just go ahead and get started with this video. Okay, the first things I want to talk about, I don't know if I've talked about these in a favorites video. I'm guessing I probably have. But with the drier months like actually here and drying my lips out, these have been a lifesaver. It's the Glam Glow Lip Treatments. So you have the Glam Glow Scrub. So this is the exfoliating scrub. It is amazing. Oh my God, it smells so good. It smells like double mint gum. And then you also have the treatment, which is amazing as well. Oh my God, this just smells like double mint gum. And it tastes really good too. Like if you accidentally taste a little bit, it tastes really good. But I love these because this does exfoliate all the dead skin off my lips. And this keeps my lips so moisturized. I'll apply it at night and then the next morning my lips are so moisturized. So I love these. I definitely recommend them. Okay, the next thing is kind of different, but I got this in a gift bag at BeautyCon when I was leaving. And I first saw it and I was like, what? It's called the Brazilian Bum Bum Cream, which I know you're probably like, girl, what? No. It is amazing. Look at this. It smells like summer to me. Oh, it just smells so good. It smells like tanning lotion a little bit to me. I don't know what it is, but I love it. And I love this because it really moisturizes my skin, but it's great for daytime because it sinks into the skin very, very quickly, which I look for in a moisturizer. I need something to really sink into my skin. I'll go for a more heavy moisturizer at night, but during the day, I need something that will just like absorb and not leave a residue. And this is perfect. I love it. I'm gonna have to look up where I can purchase this after I use it all up because I love everything about it. I even love the packaging. I just think it's the cutest little packaging ever. Okay, so my next kind of random thing is I want to talk about Scentbird. I've seen this all over YouTube and I'm like fascinated by the company. And I think this subscription service is literally worth your money. It's just amazing what they do. I mean, I'm surprised somebody hasn't come up with this before they have. This subscription is $14.95 a month. You get to pick a perfume and it comes in this huge bottle. This is how many ounces? 0.27 fluid ounces. Y'all, this is huge. Like, this is huge. I was showing Davis on the phone before I started filming this video, and I was like, this is amazing, and I was telling him about the guy ones. But anyways, so basically what it is, it's like you're trying out perfumes before you buy them, which I think is a great idea. And knowing me, look at all these perfumes, I will probably never go through all of these perfumes. Like, let's be real. I love this concept. I love perfume samples, and I think this is so cute, and I love the packaging of these because you just twist it up, and it has a really nice spray. I know that sounds really weird, but... You know how some sprays kind of come out in clumps and you're like, what the hell? And you pay like 70 bucks for it? This does not look, watch. It just comes out like a burst. Oh, it smells so good. I just wanted to shout them out because I think it's a really great brand, a really great concept, and you're basically saving a lot of money. They also have 350 different scents to choose from, which is more than any department store that I have ever been in. So I think it's awesome. You can search by like your mood and all of that other kind of stuff. But yes, $14.95 a month to try out perfumes. I just think that's amazing. So definitely check out Scentbird. Okay, moving on. I also want to mention this Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel. I actually have two face moisturizers I want to share with you guys. But this one really kind of like knocked my socks off. I tried this once before. And I was kind of like, but then I tried it again and I'm like in love with this. This is so good. The other moisturizer I'm going to show you, it kind of gets shiny on my face throughout the day. I don't really mind that, honestly. I'll just like dab it away. But this did not get oily on me at all. I was matte throughout the whole day. My skin was like really calm and it was super moisturized. It felt so refreshing on my skin. This is a damn good product. So Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel is great if you have oily skin and you want something to really sink in. And really quickly, I'm almost actually done with this one. This is the First Aid Beauty Skin Rescue, the Oil-Free Mattifying Gel. This does make you a little bit matte, but like I said, when I don't have makeup on and I go throughout the day, I will look a little bit oily in my T-zone. But this is great before your makeup because your makeup application and everything just goes on really smooth. The last skincare product I want to talk about is this Tarte Maracuja Net Treatment. I think I've talked about this before. This is the second one that I've purchased, and I forget how much I love it until I use it again, and it just makes your neck and décolleté feel so smooth. I feel like it kind of blurs imperfections in a way. Like, it looks so good. I highly recommend it, especially if you're like me and you're getting older. That's all of us, let's be real. But I'm 24, I'm really trying to take care of my skin and my neck and everything. I'm already getting some lines, but that's okay. It's life, what are you gonna do? This is really awesome at keeping you moisturized, so I highly, highly recommend it for your neck and décolleté. Alright, let's get on to the fun stuff, which is makeup. First thing I'm gonna talk about is my newest favorite foundation that, I'm not kidding, has just swept me off my feet. It's like we got married overnight. Like, it's insane. It is this Marc Jacobs foundation. I got this when I was in LA, which is like a little over a week ago. I had went shopping and I got this, and I honestly did not have high expectations for it. I knew I wanted a new foundation because I've been using the Too Faced Born This Way foundation for a while. I still love it. Don't get me wrong. I love that foundation, but I wanted to try something new, and I saw this one and I read that it was oil free, full coverage, and I was like, you know, I've never heard anybody talk about it. Why not? Wait, it's the Marc Jacobs Remarkable Full Coverage Foundation. I'm in the shade Honey Medium. I have it on right now. The only con about this is the packaging. I don't understand this concept of pulling this out and having the product on here. Like, I would much rather have a pump, and it gets a little messy, as you can see. But I love it so much that I will get past the packaging. I don't even care. I do not care about the packaging because I love this product. It makes my skin look so flawless. It is so full coverage. You need the tiniest amount. And I'm floored by it. Actually, when I wore this that night that I went out and I was self-tanned, I had wore it all night. Didn't take it off the next morning. The next day for Vlogmas, I still hadn't washed my face. You guys all know this. But Vlogmas day, I think it's 6, when I went to the smoothie shop, I hadn't washed my face, but my face still looked good. And I was like, done. I'm done. I love it. Okay, the next thing I want to shout out is this Sigma Aurora powder. It's the Cora de Rosa. And this is by Sigma. I haven't really dipped into a lot of Sigma makeup products. I mean, they come out with a lot of great stuff. Whenever Sigma does come out with makeup products, it kills usually. Like, it's usually legit stuff. It's amazing. It blends really well. I used to talk about other Sigma blushes that came out, like, I think last year or the year before, because they were amazing. Like, they're great products. So this is a new favorite. As you can tell, I like these kind of colors. I have it on my cheeks right now. This just gives a gorgeous, warm, coral shade to your cheeks, and I'm telling you, it is so beautiful. And it is just, it's the perfect powder. And this also blends really well, just like the other Sigma blushes that they had. And I love it. This is a huge pan, and I can't say enough good things about it. I used it in my last sultry holiday makeup tutorial that I just uploaded, so definitely check it out if you want to see it in action. Okay, the next thing I want to talk about, I don't know if you could still find this, but I have been using it all month and just been obsessed with it. So I would probably Google search it. If I can find it, I will link it down below. I mean, you might find it on eBay. I'm not an avid eBay buyer, but you might be able to find it on there. But this is the Bare Minerals Ready Color Boost, and this is the bronzer in The Beach is Waiting. This bronzer, you guys, gives me life. Like, I feel like I've been to the beach, and I have not. I bronzed my whole body with this because I needed to self-tan, but I didn't feel like doing it. So I dragged my foundation down and just bronzed my face, and I feel like I'm tan, and just, I love it. So this is what it looks like. You can see by the sides of it. I mean, I've used this like crazy. I used this all throughout the week I was working with Regal. I just absolutely adore this. It's so beautiful. It blends so well, and it just gives you the perfect bronze glow. This bronzer is the definition of bronze glow. I don't want to go too deep into it about how much I love it, because I do really love it. I'm gonna be sad if, like, you can't find this anywhere, but they need to relaunch this next year if they can, because I'm telling you, this is the best thing ever. Okay, the next thing that you can get is this NARS Stephen Klein blush palette. I really like it. This is the smaller one. I think you can get this on NARS.com. I know they have the bigger one on Sephora. I'm actually like lusting for that one. I might ask for it for Christmas. But this is the one that I have, and I really love it. My favorite shade is this one right here, and then this one's also my next favorite, and then this one. I don't really play with this one too much. it's not my cup of tea, but the other three are really, really nice. NARS blushes blend very well. They're very pigmented. I want to quickly shout out my Urban Decay Naked Skin. I used to not love this underneath my eyes, and now I'm obsessed with it and just cannot stop using it. I'm gonna need a new one soon. I can just feel it in my bones, but I'm in the shade medium light, and I just think this is perfect. It just blends so well. It doesn't ever look cakey. I have not used my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer all month long. So that's saying something, because I love that concealer and I haven't touched it. Urban Decay Naked Skin, definitely give it a go, especially with this Marc Jacobs foundation. It's like a match made in heaven. And since we were just talking about those two, I just want to quickly mention this brush. It's my favorite foundation brush. It's the Makeup Geek Face Buffer Brush. It is so good. I have not touched my beauty blender or anything at all. Like, I tried it in one of my other videos. I think it was the date night video, and that was filmed a while back, and I was disappointed with how the beauty blender applied my makeup. I don't know. I think I'm just so used to this brush, and the beauty blender works with different foundations really well, but I just love this one. But I just love this one so much for the Marc Jacobs foundation and the Too Faced one. It just buffs everything into the skin so beautifully. And then once I'm done with foundation and I apply concealer, I will also blend my concealer with this. So it's like a two-in-one product. I actually have this lip product on now, but it's kind of worn off. It's the gloss I'm wearing. It's the Dior Gloss in 219. The best thing about this product is I feel like out of all the things I've ever purchased from Dior, which is very small, probably like 3 items, this is the best damn thing I've ever purchased from them. So that's a swatch of it right there. It's very opaque, very glossy, but it has like this cooling sensation. So when you put it on your lips, it's like, it feels wet and it's so moisturizing, and I just love it. I love this by itself. I love it over lip products. I'm actually wearing it over Urban Decay's 1993 lip liner and then this Buxom lip foundation in Bare, which I love this color. It's so good. It's a great product to use if you're feeling like your lips are really dry or you just want that plump, glossy look and you want it to feel really good. This is it. And it's not sticky. It's perfect. It is perfection. I absolutely love it. And then what you guys have all been waiting for, music favorites. I don't know if I have a lot of music favorites, but we're gonna go with it. I do know I've been loving... Did I mention Justin Bieber last month? I feel like I have been so behind. If I haven't mentioned Justin Bieber yet, then here it is. I have been loving his song, Love Yourself. I love his part. My mama don't like you and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, but now I know. Absolutely love that song. It's so chill and easy to listen to. I mean, it's really, really good. Another thing I've been loving is Selena Gomez's Hands to Myself. Can't keep my hands to myself. No matter how hard I'm trying to. Can't keep my hands to myself. Hands to myself. Yes, girl, I hear you. And also her song Me and the Rhythm. I've been loving that too. It's so good. This is called Might Be by Luke Nasty. I just love the beat of this song. Like, when I'm working out, I'll just be like, you know? Wait. Is you rolling? I might be. You the shit, you the sugar, honey, iced tea. I love that part. You know I'm a nympho on my march. You're the shit, you're the sugar, honey, iced tea. I love that part. Okay, also, I cannot talk about favorites without talking about Bryson Tiller. Sorry Not Sorry is my new favorite. I have been listening to him constantly this month. Bryson Tiller, I mentioned him last month. You guys, he's everything. He is so good. My new favorite artist, without a doubt. And we like bitches with their own shit. We don't like gold diggers. I know you thought we had something special, but you don't mean nothing to me. Girl, I'm sorry you got the ones on me. Have you been asking why I haven't had country favorites? I just haven't heard anything really good that I've been loving that's new, so that's why I haven't included it. These songs are just ones that I have had on repeat, so I love All Hands on Deck. With Def Loaf, I think it is. Y'all.
Hands on deck. All in the front, all in the back, just like that.
Okay guys, so that is it for my favorites video this month. I really hope you liked it. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you did. And I will leave my vlog channel down below, the link to it, if you guys want to check it out and keep up with me this month. But thank you guys so much for watching. And let me know some of your favorites in the comments below. I would love to hear them. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.